So for those of you who've been living under a rock, what you're looking at right now is the newest Blender Open Movie Spring. And in this open movie, there are some warm scenes, some cool scenes, and some dual scenes, which means they represent different average colors. In fact, we can look at the average colors for all the frames to create this color timeline that Colors of Motion is selling for 18 bucks a pop. So for example, Centel gives this timeline, Agent327 gives this one, Big Buck Money gives this, and CGMatter gives this timeline. And by the way, all my patrons are getting 10 high-res timelines they can use for shirts and posters, and the rest of you will be getting absolutely nothing. So grab your keyboard, grab your mouse, and grab a snack so you too can colorize my tutorials in 3, 2, 1. So with Blender Open, extirpate the default cube, head over to the movie clip editor, and import in the footage you want to convert. Now with our footage imported, hit set scene frames to match our project in and out points, match the project frame rate to our footage, and finally switch the view transform to standard to get back our normal colors. Now in the compositing workspace, swap the render layers node for a movie clip node with our footage, and add in a scale node set to render size to fill up the frame. And remember, we want to convert this data into the average color of each frame, and we can do that by adding in 3 levels nodes set to red, green, and blue, which average out each color channel respectively. Finally, to combine these, we'll just merge them with the combine RGB node using all 3 channels, which gives us this result. And although these are the colors we want to use, we need them to appear in the correct order as a sequence of X color strips that will sweep out our timeline. To do this, just add a mask connected to our alpha set to maximum height, choose a width of 1 over the number of strips you want, and add some buffer room by nudging up the width. Now to make our mask move across the screen, we can add in a translate node set to relative, create a time node set to match our project endpoint, and subtract 0.5 from this value, which will hook into the X socket of our translate node. And effectively, this moves our mask over time from negative 0.5 to 0.5, which is exactly what we wanted, so hook these outputs to the composite node, set this to render as a PNG sequence with a step equal to our project endpoint over the number of strips, and render out the animation. And so far all we've done is taken some footage, calculated the average color of each frame, and converted this into a sweeping animation, which means we now need to find some way to overlay these strips together. The problem is I don't know an easy way to do this, so I teamed up with Andrew Price, aka Blender Guru, and here's what he had to say.
Why not go to the best textures in the world? Which is
That's great advice, Andrew. We'll go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and enable the Import Images as Planes add-on, which will let us stack our images vertically. To do this, just call the Import Images as Planes command, select your PNG sequence from before, and in our settings set the material to shadeless, choose an orientation of Z+, and also choose an alignment of Z+, as well. And now that we've imported this pancake stack, just set your camera to orthographic, reposition it so it's facing our planes head-on, and play with the orthographic scale so they fill the frame. Finally, we need our planes to be transparent so they can be overlaid, and to do this, you can either go to each plane and set the blending mode to Alpha Blend, or to keep your sanity, just go to my website, download the free script, and in the scripting workspace import in the script and execute it. This way we can now see all the way down the stack, which gives us our overlaid timeline. And to render this, we just need to go back to the compositing workspace, send a render layers node directly to the composite node, and hit render so we can save out our image. And there you go, another dead simple beginner-friendly tutorial to try while planking. I've been CGMatter, you've been you, bye-bye.